Hey everyone, I'm Satya working as Developer Evangelist with Salesforce. In this quick take, I'll show you how to work with Developer Edition or Sandbox from the VS Code. Here I am in a Developer Edition org where I have a deployed application called LWC Recipes. LWC Recipes is part of Sample Gallery, and Sample Gallery is a collection of sample apps that serves as reference code and are built with the best practices. These apps are built with latest features and continuously updated with every release. You can find the link to this from developer.salesforce.com. Okay, we'll now see how to work with this developer edition org using VS Code. We can retrieve or deploy the data into the developer edition or sandbox by using two different ways. One by using the manifest file and the other by using the org browser. Let us first see how we can use the manifest file with the developer edition or sandbox. Launch the command palette, type sfdx and choose create a project with a manifest file. This will launch a little wizard. Let us select a standard project template, give the name as say sandbox demo and create the project. It creates a project with Salesforce DX project scaffolding. You can learn more about creating the Salesforce development project with VS Code from the quick take linked in the description below. You can see a message that no default org is set. We'll go ahead and add our developer org or sandbox as the default org to this project. We can use sfdx set default org command from the command palette, or we can click the no default org set icon at the left bottom. This will launch the command palette and run sfdx set default org command for us. You can authorize an org or select an existing org. I have already authorized my org, so I'll select an existing org. You can see in the Salesforce CLI output that it runs an equivalent CLI command for us. Now, let's go to the Explorer and expand the manifest folder. Here, we can see a file named package.xml. Let's open it. You can modify this file to keep only the metadata that you will be working with in your project. For instance, I only want to work on Apex classes. So I will keep the Apex classes and delete other entries and save it. Now, right-click anywhere in this package.xml file and select retrieve source in manifest from org. You can see in the Salesforce CLI output tab that all the Apex classes are retrieved. Let's now go and open the classes folder in the Force app to find the retrieved classes. Force app stores all the metadata and source files in your project. Here you can see that it has retrieved the classes from the org to the local machine. Okay, as I said earlier, there is another way of retrieving the data. That is by using the org browser, in which case we need not use the manifest file. Let's check how it works by creating an empty project. Let's now close this folder and launch the command palette and type sfdx. This time, I'll choose create project instead of the project with manifest file. If you wish, you can choose a standard project template, but let us choose an empty project template as it generates the basic scaffolding with a lesser number of folders. Let us give a name as org browser demo and create project. Just like earlier, you can see the no default org is set message. We'll go ahead and add our developer org or sandbox as the default org to this project. Let us click the no default org set at the left bottom and select an org from the command palette. Now you can see an org browser logo that looks like a cloud icon in the activity bar on the left. This logo will be visible whenever you set your developer edition or sandbox as a default org. Let us click that. It shows the org's metadata in the view pane. You can click any of those folders to retrieve the metadata. Now, I want to work on a Hello Lightning component. I can search for the Lightning components, select that folder, and find the Hello component. When you hover over the Hello component, you can see the retrieve source from org icon that looks like a cloud download symbol. Let's click that to retrieve the source. Now, let's open the Explorer. You can see the LWC folder in which our component is retrieved. You can selectively retrieve any metadata that you wish to work on. Let's now go ahead and make some modifications in the hello.js file and save it. We can also check the changes that we have made in this file by using the feature diff file against org. It is going to compare this file with that in the org. Right click anywhere in the file and choose diff file against org from the context menu. You can now verify the changes that we have made. Okay, let us now deploy the changes by right clicking anywhere on the file and selecting deploy the source to org. When we are working on a developer edition or sandbox org, we will be specifically deploying a folder or a file using the deploy the source to org command. Now let's launch the org from the browser. Open the app. And here you can see the applied changes. That's all in this quick take. I hope you like this video. Also watch our quick take which covers working with Salesforce Scratch org using VS Code, linked in the description below. Thanks for watching this quick take. If you learned something, be sure to like this video. If you want to get more content like this pushed directly to you, click subscribe and that bell to get notifications.